Hello friends, welcome to YouTube channel Electronics. In this video, we will learn how to do binary addition and subtraction. Electronic devices like computers made our life simple and faster. These devices contain most important integrated circuit chips like microprocessors and microcontrollers. If we observe the block diagram of these integrated chips, we can identify a most important block, that is ALU, arithmetic logic unit, which performs all arithmetic and logic functions like addition, subtraction, and OR logic, and etc. ALU executes these operations based on binary inputs or binary numbers. Hence, it is essential to learn arithmetic operations of binary numbers. Let's see how to do binary addition. Each and every binary digit have some weight by the power of 2. Starting from right to left, like here 2 to the power of 0, 2 to the power of 1 and so on. Here the decimal equivalent of first binary number is 10 and the second one is 15. In decimal number system, to add numbers we use column method. We always add least digit in the right first and continue adding the digits towards the highest digit in the left. Similarly, to add two binary numbers, we must follow the same column method from last digit in right to highest digit in left. The following rules must be followed for binary addition. In binary, 0 plus 0 equals to 0, 0 plus 1 equals to 1. And 1 plus 0 also equals to 1. But 1 plus 1 equals to 0 with 1 as carry to the next column. In decimal number system, 1 plus 1 equals to 2. The binary equivalent of 2 is 0, 1. So when we do binary addition of 1 plus 1, then we write 0 as answer with 1 as carry to the next column. Similarly, if we are adding 1 plus 1 with a carry of 1 from previous column, then the answer is 1 with a carry of 1 to the next column. In decimal number system, 1 plus 1 plus 1 equals to 3. The binary equivalent of 3 is 1, 1. Therefore, when we are doing binary addition of 1 plus 1 plus 1, then we write 1 as answer with 1 as carry to the next column. Here, these two rules are very critical in binary addition. Now, let's solve some examples so that we will get clear idea of binary addition. Here, we must follow the column by column addition method and we must start adding rightmost column digits first and we will proceed towards left side. Please refer these rules for better understanding. Here rightmost column digits are 0 plus 0, that will be equals to 0. In the next column the digits are 1 plus 1 which gives answer 0 with carry of 1 to the next column. So now if we move to the next column, we have a carry of 1 from previous column addition and 1 and 0 digits in this column. Hence here we have to add 1 plus 1 plus 0, that equals to 0 with 1 as carry to the next column. So in the last column we have to add 3 ones, 2 ones of this column and 1 carry from the previous column. This will give answer 1 with a carry of 1 to the next column. Since we don't have any columns further for addition, we will directly write the 1 in the answer. So this is the binary number which we got after the addition. Now let's check whether our addition is correct or not. Here we will convert these binary numbers into decimal number equivalent. To convert them, first we will write the weights of each digit. It is power of 2 from right to left. So the decimal equivalent of the first binary number is 8 plus 4 plus 2 plus 0. that equals to 14. And the decimal equivalent of second binary number is 8 plus 0 plus 2 plus 0, that equals to 10. So the decimal addition of 14 plus 10 equals to 24. If we convert this binary addition result to decimal, it is also 16 plus 8 plus 0, that is equals to 24. That means our binary addition is correct. This is how we can perform the binary addition. Now let's see how to add two binary fractional numbers. To add the fractional numbers, first of all, we need to align the radix point of both numbers. And in answer, we will get the radix point just below these two points in the same column. Here also same binary rules needs to be followed. Addition is performed by column by column method. And we must start from the rightmost column and will move towards the left side. So first add rightmost column numbers. They were 1 plus 0, that equals to 1. Then next column numbers. Here we will add 2 ones, that is equals to 0 with carry 1 to the next column. In next column, we have to add 1 plus 0 plus 1. Here 1 plus 0 equals to 1. So it is nothing but 1 plus 1. That gives answer 0 with carry 1 to the next column. Here the radix point must be aligned with the above numbers. Now in next column, we have 1 plus 0 plus 1 like before. So it is nothing but 1 plus 1, that is equals to 0 with 1 as carry to next column. In this column, we need to add 1 plus 0 plus 0, that equals to 1. Then we move to next column. Here this is simple. 1 plus 0, that equals to 1. Now in the last column, we have 0 plus 1, that is nothing but 1. So after adding these two binary fractional numbers, we got answer 1110.001. So this is how we can do binary addition. Now let's see how to do binary subtraction. First of all, let's understand rules for the binary subtraction. In binary, 0 minus 0 equals to 0, while 1 minus 0 equals to 1, and 1 minus 1 equals to 0. But 0 minus 1 equals to 1 when 1 is borrowed from the next column. Here 0 is lesser than 1, so we cannot subtract and we must borrow 1 from the next column. So these are the rules for binary subtraction. First three rules are simple and just like normal decimal number system subtraction. To understand the last rule, we will solve some examples. So let's subtract these two binary numbers. Here also we will follow column by column method. As we know that each column has a weight in multiples of 2 from right to left. Just like arithmetic subtraction, we must start from least value digit, that is the rightmost column. Here it is 0 minus 1. Since 0 is lesser than 1, so we need to borrow from the next column. For example, in decimal number system subtraction, whenever we are borrowing from next column, we reduce the digit by 1 and carry this 1 to the right column as a value of 10. And we will do the subtraction. It is because in case of decimal number system, the place value of each digit increases by 10 times. But in case of binary number system, the place value of each digit increases by 2 times. This is very important point to remember while doing binary calculations. Let's get back to our binary subtraction. Here to understand easily, we will refer each column by its weight. Now we have to borrow from 2's column to 1's column. So we will replace this 1 by 0 because this 1 is borrowed by 1's column. The weight of 1 in 2's column is 2. So whenever we put this 1 in 1's column, we must represent it as 2 times 1. Or we can say that there are 2 ones in 1's column. So after subtracting 1 1 from 2 ones, we will get 1 in the answer. This is what I have mentioned in last rule of binary subtraction. 0 minus 1 equals to 1 whenever 1 is borrowed from next column. Now we will move to the next column. In 2's column, we have 0 because 1 is already borrowed to 1's column. So here it is 0 minus 1. So once again, we need to borrow from next column since 0 is lesser than 1. In the next column, the weight of the 1 is equal to 4. So first this 1 will be replaced by 0, and whenever this 4 goes into 2's column, it becomes 2 times 2. So now if we perform the subtraction, then we are actually subtracting 2 2's minus 1 2, that is equals to 1 2. So we write 1 as the answer in 2's column. Hence, whenever we are borrowing from next column, we will write it as 2 in that particular column. Because in binary number system, each digit's place value increases by 2 times. We must always remember this phenomena while doing binary subtraction. So now let's move to the next column, that is 4's column. Here we have 0 minus 0, that is equals to 0. Now we will move to the 8's column. Here it is 1 minus 1, that equals to 0. So after the subtraction, we will get 0, 0, 1, 1 as the result. So now let's convert these binary numbers into decimal numbers to check the answer. Here the decimal equivalent of first binary number 1, 1, 1, 0 equals to 8 plus 4 plus 2 plus 0, that is 14. And the decimal equivalent of 1, 0, 1, 1 is 8 plus 0 plus 2 plus 1, that is 11. So 14 minus 11 equals to 3, that is nothing but 1 1 in binary number system. Hence our binary subtraction is correct. So now let's move to the next example. Here to subtract these two binary numbers, once again we will follow column by column method. Before starting the subtraction, let me mention the weights of each column. As we know that subtraction must start from the ones column. Here it is 0 minus 1. Since 0 is lesser than 1, we need to borrow from the 2's column. But if we observe over here, in 2's column also there is a 0. So we cannot borrow a 1 from 2's column. Hence we need to borrow from its next column, that is 4's column. In 4's column, we have 1. So first we will borrow this 1 to 2's column. First we will replace the 1 in 4's column by 0. And whenever we are putting this 1 in 2's column, then we will represent it as 2 times 2. It is because the 1 in 4's column is equals to 4. Now here we have 2 2's in this 2's column. Out of these 2 2's, we will keep 1 2 in this 2's column. So this 0 will be replaced by 1. And the other 2 will be borrowed to the 1's column. So in 1's column also, this 2 will be represented as 2 times 1. Because the place value of 1 in the 2's column is 2. So now in 1's column, it is 2 1's minus 1 1. That is 1 as the answer. That is because 0 minus 1 is 1 whenever we are borrowing 1 from the next column. In 2's column, it is simple. 1 minus 1, that equals to 0. Now if we move to the next column, that is 4's column, again we have 0 minus 1. Since 0 is lesser than 1, we must borrow from next column, that is 8's column. So in 8's column, we will replace this 1 with 0, and this 1 will be taken to the 4's column. The weight of the 1 in 8's column is 8. So we must write it as 2 times 4 in the 4's column. Now in 4's column, we have 2 4's. If we subtract this 2 4's minus 1 4, we will get 1 in the answer. Here also same rule have been applied. 0 minus 1 equals to 1 whenever we borrow 1 from the next column. Now in the next 8's column, we have 0 minus 0, that equals to 0. So after performing the subtraction between these two binary numbers, we got 0101 as the answer. Now let's convert them into decimal number system to check the answer. The decimal equivalent of first binary number 1100 equals to 8 plus 4 plus 0 plus 0, that equals to 14. And second binary number 0111 equals to 4 plus 2 plus 1, that is 7. So 12 minus 7 equals to 5. That is nothing but 101 in the binary number system. Hence our subtraction is correct. Now let's solve the final example so that it will get clear to you. To perform subtraction between these two binary numbers, once again we will do the column by column subtraction. Let's represent the weights of each column. Here the least place value digit, that is rightmost column, have 0 minus 1. Since 0 is lesser than 1, we need to take borrow from next column. But if you observe over here, next 3 columns have 0 in their digits. So we cannot get borrow from these 3 columns. We can only take borrow from the last column, that is 16th column. Here the borrow will come step by step to the first column. Once we borrow this one from 16th column, we mark it as 0 and will represent this one as 2 times 8 in 8th column, because the weight of 1 in 16th column is 16. So out of these 2 8s, we will keep 1 in this 8th column and the other one will be borrowed to the 4th column. Here this 1 8 will be represented as 2 times 4 in the 4th column because of its weight. Here also out of these 2 4s, one will be kept in this particular column and the other one will be borrowed to the 2's column. Once again this 4 can be written as 2 times 2 in this 2's column. Here also the same method. 1 2 will be kept in this 2's column and the other 2 will be borrowed to the 1's column. These 2 will be represented as 2 times 1 in the 1's column. So finally we have 2 1's in 1's column. This is how we can borrow from the last column to the first column. Now in this rightmost column it is 2 times 1 minus 1, that is equals to 1. Similarly, in 2's column, it is 1 minus 1, that is equals to 0. And likewise, in 4's column also, it is 1 minus 1, that is equals to 0. In 8's column also same, 1 minus 1, that is equals to 0. Now, if we move to the last column, it is 0 minus 0, that is equals to 0. This is how we perform binary subtraction. Here after subtraction we have 00001 as the answer. Let's convert them as decimal numbers to check the answer. The decimal equivalent of first binary number is 16 plus zeros, that is 16. And the second binary number is 8 plus 4 plus 2 plus 1, that is 15. So 16 minus 15 equals to 1. That is nothing but 1 in binary number system. Here our subtraction is perfect. That's all about addition and subtraction of binary number system. If you have learned from this video, please do mention them in the comment section below. Thanks for watching. If you like this video, please click the like button. Help others to learn by sharing this video. Please subscribe and turn on notifications for more such videos. Have a nice day.